See why we have created a device. Actually, we have created our device so we can check the performance of the car. If we can extract the critical data of the car and continuously monitor, save it, then we can check the performance. The data which we collect helps the manufacturer as well as the technicians to make more quicker and effective repairs. And that also saves time and money. And in a way, if we make the health of the car better, the pollution, we can reduce the pollution of the world. And this is what our device targets for. Plus, for that, for global connectivity, we have put a internet connectivity into it. We have created a Wi-Fi card which will send data to the internet. And that when we send data to the internet, any manufacturer or the technician can look up the data. So if any error crops in the car, the error can be analyzed by the manufacturer, which I have told you before. So this is why we have created a device.
Talking about the hardware components, includes the Dr. Microfiber board, which already is there, and then we are using SD card, which is a standard SD card, and the main device which talks with the car is LM327, and this LM327 is connected to the serial port of the device, and this LM327 goes into the car and which communicates with the car. So this is actually this has a chip called LM327, and this is totally communicates with the car. Our device is sending data from the car to the internet via this ethernet cable. We are not using Wi-Fi right now, as we are not able to get the Wi-Fi device. So in place of it, we are using this Ethernet cable, which is sending data directly to the internet.
The data from the device goes over to the server and as a request to the server, and server accepts a request and it stores in this database which is a car data database, which we have made it, and the data stored in the database then can be viewed in our website for the car, which we'll also show you, and the website was. So this is our website car performance analyzer, which has a sign in for all the users, and according to sign in, every user will have its car account, which will have all the data stored in it in a database for each and every user, and the database, the graphs can be drawn from that database. So we have just made the database, and we can show you the database which is being made by the uploaded data, and from that we can generate the graphs. And each and every user will have a separate account so that he can always view his data wherever he likes. Even the GPS data would also be uploaded. Okay, so this is what it is. So let's try. This card is going to beep, so it will be fast, slow.
Yes, connected.
Now it's connected. Now we can click on the center of the tabs to go to the main screen and see what the data is coming.
for standby mode, you have to click on the red screen and it opens. This is what a screen has disappeared and there's nothing, and the device is going in the powerless mode.
Switch on.
Now I can go back to the main menu. You touch screen, nothing will happen. So you have to click on the center, you push this tab, and again the main menu comes. Go in your. Yeah. Switch on.
When you come to the cost variability of our product, the cost of the device is 15,000 and the cost of the ALM327 device which you purchased from the IRA Technologies in India is 4,500 rupees, which is as an OBD2 device, right? But we said already, we said that a unique feature of our product is internet connection, that is capable of uploading data from our car to the server. But this is, can be possible by using Wi-Fi device. This Wi-Fi device is directly plugged into Ethernet port of our device. But when you use a Wi-Fi connection, this may affect our marketing globally, our product marketing globally, because only the US, but we see that only the US government has a Wi-Fi connection all over the country. But when you compare to the other countries, example India, we don't have the Wi-Fi connection. Moreover, we can upload the data into server using the GPRS also, but with a less speed, which can be applicable in India with a low cost. So we simulated our design in such a way that it can be capable of both GPRS and Wi-Fi. So we can sell, that doesn't mean that we sell both the things, but thing is that we sell the things which is a user requirement, user feasibility and user capability. Depending on him, we'll keep an option in such a way which he needs, and depending on his requirement, we sell the product. That's only one device can able to run both the devices, that is Wi-Fi device and as another GPRS device, and so that we can able to applicable in the marketable in the global. And
when we were making user interface, WPF helped us quite a lot, and making a user interface with all the events tied up is very, it becomes very easy when you're using Dr. McAfee to make it. Plus, using flat screen and the Ethernet was just a cup of tea.
While making the user interface, we were using WPF and the Windows Presenting Foundation, all of this, you know, and it helped us a lot to make the user interface, and it was just so easy to make it, and it was possible with Dr. Microframework. And also the Ethernet and touchscreen, using it was just like about using the code, and it was just so simple. One factor we really encountered, that the speed response time of the device was quite slow. So we would like Dr. Framework team to look into the device response, to look into the speed of the swiftness of the program that we don't have any control on. And that is what we want Dr. Fair to look into. And we hope that the newer versions of Dr. Framework will have better swiftness, speed and response. So that's for hoping. Thank you.
Bye.